Hardly did it come to the knowledge of all that one day a born Muslim barrack boy would become a world preacher. Celebrating 25 years behind the pulpit, a ministry that started as prevailing evangelical theme, Beth, became Overcomers Prevailing Evangelical Ministry, OPEM, and later transformed into Champions Assembly International.
A war, it might be a man like Jesus from the Lenta. wanted to lose you. Then he was born in the manger. And he was not born there. He did not take him to the palace. I want you to know, of your life, this is your manger. It can be small, but you never go to use it. From it, you go to the ultimate part of the earth. You are going to hear, people are going to hear your name because you are called of what? The law. You are only entitled to one wife and one offer. And that's why your parents are here. Anytime you see them going and say, I want to marry you, I tell my member, you cannot meet up my need at all. I am not a beggar, and that's why I will not beg you. I have been in this world for 10 years, and the Lord is supplying all my needs. I have not gone out to beg. And that's why I know whatever God is doing, is doing them. It's not possible. Whenever God wants to do something, and God tells you, my son, I am going to bless you, I'm going to move to him, all God wants you to do is to get prepared with a new heart. God will not approach your heart if your heart is affected with old ideas. What God is doing in this end time, it brings new ideas. Ladies and gentlemen, there came a time the lion confronted the children of Israel for good 40 days. I'm not talking about how David fought Goliath, but there was something particular about the life of David that I know that God wanted to hear today. The Bible said that David was in the wilderness, rearing animals. Some of you are in the wilderness, nobody knows you. You are in the place where nobody knows you. You have been selling tomatoes and you're a businesswoman. You have been selling parrots, you're a businessman. Nobody understands you. The Bible said David was in the place reading. Nobody knew him. Nobody knew what God wanted to do with David. But somewhere along the line, David was opportune to attend the fighting competition of Goliath and the children of Israel. A single man standing up against a whole country, all the artillery and chief of army staff. There was nobody that can stand up to fight a single man. And David came there and was talking. And when David was talking, David said, no, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Why should he stay here? What is he doing here? What is it? Why is he fighting and defiling the army of the living God? He was so much provoked. Then the Bible said the eldest brother of David came, Eliab. He said, you this small boy, short man, lingering a carrot. What are you going to do in this practice? We have armor bearer people who have come to NDA, who have attended the first army staff college. What are you doing here? And he said, will you keep quiet? What are you saying? Go back home and sit on Philip Battle. David said, I have not met the sleep on Philip Battle. I have been trained in the wilderness. Every man that comes out of the wilderness comes out to fulfill destiny. And that's what I want to talk on. It is my turn to fulfill destiny. It is my turn to fulfill destiny. From going there, God is going to create a battle tonight. And God is going to create a Goliath tonight. That nobody in your family will be able to fight. Except you're going to put the key of the kingdom in your hands. God will put the key of the kingdom in your hands. God will give some people sickness so that you can pray for them to be healed. So that you might fulfill destiny. Somebody will have problem and God, you are going to be the only solution. Because it is your turn to fulfill destiny. Because it is your turn to fulfill destiny. You are going to fulfill destiny in the name of Jesus. So many years ago, I was in Ottawa when we started the ministry. And somewhere along the line, I remember one time when I was in Ottawa and I was pastoring on an Akongeri assembly. And there was troubles. I had to drive from Ottawa to Ajilete. If you look at that journey, it was a journey as a mile. I dragged it and take it. When I got home around 12 o'clock in the midnight, I slept on my bed and said, God, if this is how ministry is, I am not going to serve you any longer. I am tired. And the word of the Lord came to me. He said, Joshua, you are the next agenda in my program. You are the next stop in my program. Maybe somebody here, you have been wondering.
only God sent me to tell you that it is your turn to fulfill destiny. Tell the day it is my turn. It is my turn. That's no wrong thing this morning, my teacher Johan. I want to show you what God wants me to push to you this morning right now. Mighty 21. As they approach Jerusalem, you are going to approach Jerusalem in the name of Jesus. There is a Jerusalem.
And now, Champions Royal Assembly, the difference is clear. Brother Joshua Iginla, before and now. Years of grace.
Hear this. Deliverance is the gateway to holiness. Now hear this. Holiness is the twin brother of deliverance. You are looking at me? Look at the scripture. There shall be deliverance and there shall be holiness. So any place you see deliverance, holiness appear. If there is no deliverance, there can be no holiness. What you are now was not what the master architect of your destiny designed. You are not getting me. What you are going through now, that was not how it was designed from the beginning. What you are going through now, it was not how it was designed. There are some consultants, spiritual consultants, that have been consulted because of your destiny to redesign and to make some structural failures and to make some structural blunders about your destiny. That is why you are having what I call structural collapse in your destiny, because the master architect of life never designed you not to have a child. Never designed you not to have a baby. Never designed you to be barren. Never designed you to be jobless. Never designed you to be a divorcee. Never designed you to cry. Never designed you to carry that sickness. There is somebody trying to abort your destiny. Whenever you aspire to be great, or you desire to be great, or you are a child of destiny and prophecy, storms are part of the things that checkmate your heart and your relationship with God.
Hear this. Holiness is not the absence of prosperity. Holiness is the smooth running of prosperity and purity. Lazarus did not make heaven because he was poor. He made heaven because he had personal encounter with Jesus. Jesus was never a poor man. He never preached the gospel of poverty. In Luke, he said, "For the Spirit of the Lord God has anointed me to preach the good tidings to the poor." The first thing that Jesus said, "The Spirit of God has anointed me to proclaim good tidings to the poor." Hear this. In Zechariah 1:17, he said, "For by prosperity shall my city be spread abroad." Not by prayer.
I love the Abrahamic covenant. So sweet. But I can tell you the Abrahamic price is so great. Never you say Abraham's blessing am mine without Abraham's suffering being yours. You don't claim promises until you have fulfilled the conditionalities.
Five years of wonders still affecting life. 5 years of ministerial impact, transforming destinies. General Brother Joshua Iginla will be celebrating 25 years behind the pulpit. 25 years doing what he was born to do, and will be launching 33 mind-blowing classical books, all written by God's servant Brother Joshua Iginla. Date Sunday 28th of June 2015. Time 6 a.m. prompt. Venue International Headquarters, Champion City of Wonders, Chikwere, Kubwa, Abuja, Nigeria. It's an event you can't afford to miss. 25 years behind the pulpit.